So now coming lecture number 2, we are going to start new chapter, water. So we know that water is very important part for us, and our 1/3 part of the land, okay, 1/3 not 3/4, great, our 3/4 part of the land is covered with water. Most of the land covered with water, and water is very important for us. We use water in many ways. We use water for bathing, we use water for drinking, we use water for washing clothes, we use water for washing our cars, we use water for watering plants also. Plants need also water for making their food also. Animals need also water for making their food also. And so water are very important in all the ways. But nowadays, whatever water are present on our land, it is very dirty. So we have to make it clean. How we make it clean? We can make it clean either by boiling or either by filtering. So now come to page number 117, sources of water. From where we use to get this water. So sources of water. So we get water from three sources. First is rain water, second is surface water, and third is ground water. First is which comes in the form of rain, second is that surface which is found on the earth surface, and the third is which is found in the ground, means when we dig any well, then we can find this water. So we can, we get water from three sources. So first is rain water, second is surface water, and third one is ground water. So these three things are there. So first we'll come to rain water. So rain is the main source of water on earth. The water that we get from rain is called rain water. Because if there will be no rain, then there will be a lot of problems. That will be a problem for our poor farmer also. If they will not get proper amount of rain, so whatever the crops are there, they will not grow. Okay. And rain is often important for aquatic animals also. So rain is the main source of water on earth. Okay. So the water that we get from rain is called rain water. So our once rain water falls on the ground, where do you think that it goes? Some rain water flows in the water body, such as ponds and lakes and rivers. Some water goes into the ground also. Okay, when there is rain, they falls and they flows into the river, ponds, lake, and some they goes into the land also, into the ground. So once rain water falls on the ground, okay, it flows into water bodies such as ponds, lakes, and river, and some water also goes into the there are three things: rain water, surface water, and ground water. Rain water, that is rain, is the source of rain water, and that water that we get from rain, that is known as rain water. Once rain water falls on the ground, it flows into water bodies such as ponds, lakes, and even some water also goes into the ground also. So now we move to surface water. So the water that is present in water bodies on the surface of the earth is called surface water. Okay, the water that is present in water body, on the surface of the water that is present on the water body, but on the surface of water, where the water bodies are there, and on there whatever land are there on that surface, that is known as rain water. The water that is present in water body on the surface of the earth, mean earth is there, land is there, on that land water is there, so that we can say surface water. So the water that is present in water bodies on the surface of the earth, is called surface water. So water bodies such as ponds, lakes, rivers, streams, seas, and oceans are different sources of surface water. Okay, examples are these only: ponds, lakes, rivers, because they all are on the surface of land. Rivers, seas, streams, okay, are the different sources of surface water. Water in ponds, lakes, and river and stream is not salty. This water is called fresh water. The water in ponds, lake, rivers, and streams is not salty, and this water is called fresh water. Okay, this water is called fresh water. This sea water is known as salty water, but this type of water in ponds, lakes, and rivers and stream is not salty, and this water is called fresh water. So here I am stopping. In next classes I will go for lakes and ponds water, rivers and stream, how is their form, and seas and oceans. So till here I am stopping. So for now, goodbye to all of you.